Lord are my lamp. The Lord turns my darkness into light.
I will praise you, Lord, among the nations. I will sing the praises of your name.
You are strong. You are Lord, and I am brave, cause I am sure who you say I am.
Today's Bible reading comes from 1 Samuel chapter 7 verses 3 to 12. And Samuel said to all the house of Israel, If you are returning to the Lord with all your heart, then put away the foreign gods and the Ashtaroth from among you, and direct your heart to the Lord, and serve him only, and he will deliver you out of the hand of the Philistines. So the people of Israel put away the Baals and the Ashtaroth, and they served the Lord only. Then Samuel said, Gather all Israel at Mizpah, and I will pray to the Lord for you. So they gathered at Mizpah and drew water and poured it out before the Lord and fasted on that day and said there, We have sinned against the Lord. And Samuel judged the people of Israel at Mizpah. Now when the Philistines heard that the people of Israel had gathered at Mizpah, the lords of the Philistines went up against Israel. And when the people of Israel heard of this, they were afraid of the Philistines. And the people of Israel said to Samuel, Do not cease to cry out to the Lord for our God for us, that he may save us from the hand of the Philistines. So Samuel took a nursing lamb and offered it as a whole burnt offering to the Lord. And Samuel cried out to the Lord for Israel, and the Lord answered him. As Samuel was offering up the burnt offering, the Philistines drew near to attack Israel. But the Lord thundered with a mighty sound that day against the Philistines and threw them into confusion, and they were defeated before Israel. And the men of Israel went out from Mizpah and pursued the Philistines and struck them as far as below Bethkar. Then Samuel took a stone and set it up between Mizpah and Shen and called its name Ebenezer. For he said, Till now the Lord has helped us. This is God's word for us today. Thanks be to God.
샬롬! 사랑하는 제일교회 아동부 친구들, 그리고 지금 이 시간 우리와 함께 온라인 예배를 드리고 있는 모든 친구들을 환영합니다. 우리 친구들, 지난주에 하나님께서 사무엘을 부르시고 이스라엘을 이끌어갈 마지막 사사로 세우신 것을 배웠었죠? 사무엘은 하나님의 말씀을 듣고 백성들에게 바르게 전했기 때문에 이스라엘 사람들은 모두 사무엘의 말을 따랐어요. 그런데 그 당시 이스라엘에게는 큰 문제가 있었는데요. 그건 바로 블레셋이라는 나라였어요. 블레셋은 이스라엘을 자꾸 공격해오고 전쟁을 일으키며 이스라엘을 괴롭혔죠. 자, 이 두 나라 사이에 어떤 일이 벌어졌는지 오늘의 이야기를 함께 들어볼까요?
Israel misuses the ark, 1 Samuel 4 through 7. The Philistines were Israel's strongest enemies during the days of Samuel, Israel's last judge. One day the Philistine army fought the Israelites and killed 4,000 Israelite soldiers. When Israel's army returned, their leaders wondered, "Why did the Lord let the Philistines beat our army?" Instead of praying to God for help, they decided to take the Ark of the Covenant with them into the next battle. They thought the Ark would save them from defeat. The Ark of the Covenant was the special altar where God met with his people. But the Ark was not a good luck charm. The Israelites needed to learn to trust God himself and not the symbol of God. The two sons of Eli, the high priest, took the Ark to the battlefront. When the people saw the ark, they gave such a great shout that the Philistines heard them. When the Philistines learned about the ark, they were afraid. They had heard about the problems God had brought on the Egyptians. Because they were afraid, the Philistines fought even harder. This time they killed 30,000 Israelites, including Eli's two sons, and they captured the Ark of the Covenant from Israel. A messenger returned to tell Eli the bad news. When he heard the Philistines had captured the ark, he was so sad that he fell backwards off his chair and died. Israel cried out. They felt as if God was no longer with them. Meanwhile, the Philistines took the ark to a city called Ashdod and put it in a temple next to a statue of their god, Dagon. The next morning, the people of Ashdod found Dagon lying face down on the ground before the ark. They picked up the idol and put it back on its pedestal. The same thing happened the next morning, except the statue's head and hands were broken off and found in the temple doorway. Only the one true God could have done this. God caused trouble for the people of Ashdod. They had tumors on their bodies, and rats overran their city. They sent the ark to another city called Gath, but the people there became sick too. The people of Gath sent the ark to a city called Ekron, but the people there complained and demanded the ark be returned to Israel. Many of the people of Ekron died or had tumors. The people cried out because of the trouble God brought on them. The Ark of the Covenant was with the Philistines for 7 months. Finally, they called their priests and magicians together and asked how they could send the Ark back to Israel. The priests and magicians answered, "When you send back the Ark, offer gifts to the God of Israel so you will be healed. Make 5 golden tumors and 5 golden rats, one for each of the 5 Philistine leaders. Put the gifts in a chest and put it and the ark on a new wagon. Hitch it to 2 milk cows that have just given birth and have never pulled a wagon. Send the wagon in the direction of Israel." The 2 mother cows would not normally leave their young calves, but God caused them to stay on the road toward Israel. They mooed all the way. The people of a place called Beth Shemesh on the border of Israel were harvesting wheat when they spotted the wagon and the Ark of the Covenant. They were happy to see the Ark. When the cows stopped near a large rock in a field, the Levites put the Ark and the chest on the large stone. They chopped up the wagon and used the wood to offer the cows to the Lord as a burnt offering. But some of the people of Beth Shemesh sinned against God when they looked into the ark. God's law demanded that the ark stay closed and covered when it was not in the tabernacle. God killed more than 50,000 men because they did not respect him. The people of Beth Shemesh were afraid. They sent for a priest named Abinadab to come get the ark. Abinadab brought the ark to the house of his son Eleazar, where it stayed for 20 years. During all that time, the Israelites continued to war with the Philistines. Finally, Israel cried out to God. Samuel told them they must put away their idols and worship God alone. When they admitted their sin before the Lord, Samuel prayed for them and made a sacrifice. The next time Israel battled the Philistines, God confused the Philistines with a loud clap of thunder. The Israelites won the battle. God gave Israel peace as Samuel served as God's judge in the land. God taught the Israelites that he would never leave them. He also taught them to worship him alone. God won't leave us either. Since God is always with us, we should worship him and serve him the rest of our lives.
와, 아주 흥미진진한 이야기였죠? 이스라엘과 블레셋 두 나라 사이에 있었던 전쟁 이야기인데요. 그런데 여기서 아주 중요한 물건이 등장하는데 그게 뭐였죠? 네, 바로 언약궤라고 하는 거예요. 이 언약궤가 뭐길래 이렇게 두 전쟁 사이에서 중요한 물건이었을까요? 언약궤는 모세가 애굽에서 이스라엘 백성을 이끌고 나온 출애굽 당시에 하나님께서 모세를 시내산으로 부르시고 시내산 위에서 모세에게 십계명이 새겨진 돌판을 주시기 전에 성막, 곧 하나님을 예배할 장소를 만들라고 하시면서 이 언약궤도 만들라고 하셨어요. 자, 다음 영상을 통해서 언약궤에 대해 조금 더 자세히 알아볼게요.
And they shall make an ark of acacia wood. 2.5 cubits shall be its length, a cubit and a half its width, and a cubit and a half its height. A and you shall overlay it with pure gold. Inside and out you shall overlay it, and shall make on it a molding of gold all around. You shall cast four rings of gold for it, and put them in its four corners. Two rings shall be on one side, and two rings on the other side. And you shall make poles of acacia wood, and overlay them with gold. You shall put the poles into the rings on the sides of the ark, that the ark may be carried by them. The poles shall be in the rings of the ark, they shall not be taken from it. And you shall put into the ark the testimony which I will give you. You shall make a mercy seat of pure gold. 2.5 cubits shall be its length, and 1.5 cubits its width. And you shall make 2 cherubim of gold, of hammered work you shall make them at the 2 ends of the mercy seat. Make 1 cherub at 1 end, and the other cherub at the other end, and you shall make the cherubim at the 2 ends of it 1 piece with the mercy seat. And the cherubim shall stretch out their wings above, covering the mercy seat with their wings, and they shall face one another. The faces of the cherubim shall be toward the mercy seat. You shall put the mercy seat on top of the ark, and in the ark you shall put the testimony that I will give you. And there I will meet with you, and I will speak with you from above the mercy seat, from between the 2 cherubim which are on the ark of the testimony, about everything which I will give you in commandment to the children of Israel.
우리가 본 것처럼 이 언약궤 안에는 하나님이 직접 써주신 십계명, 이 새겨진 돌판이 들어있었고, 그러니까 이 언약궤는 이스라엘 백성에게 아주 신성하고 거룩한 물건이었어요. 이것은 하나님의 임재를 상징했고, 하나님의 말씀이 흘러나온 곳이었으며, 죄를 용서받는 일이 일어나는 곳이었던 거예요. 이스라엘 사람들이 블레셋과의 싸움에서 자꾸만 지게 되자 언약궤를 전쟁터로 가져오자 라고 했던 것은 지금까지 이스라엘이 전쟁에서 승리할 때마다 이 언약궤가 아주 중요한 역할을 했다고 생각했기 때문이에요. 그러나 이것은 잘못된 생각이었어요. 승리를 주시는 분은 하나님 그 자체이지 하나님을 상징하는 언약궤라는 물건이 아니었거든요. 그래서 언약궤를 전쟁터로 가져온 이스라엘 군대는 어떻게 되었나요? 승리했나요? 아니죠. 네, 전쟁에서 완전히 패배했고 그렇게 중요하게 생각했던 언약궤마저 블레셋 군대에게 빼앗기고 말았어요. 블레셋 사람들은 신이 났을 거예요. 지금까지 이스라엘을 지켜주던 이 언약궤가 우리 손에 들어왔으니 이제 이스라엘은 끝장이야 하면서 자신들의 섬기던 우상, 다곤이 있는 신전에 언약궤를 갖다 놓죠. 그 다음은 어떻게 되었나요? 하룻밤 사이에 다곤 신상이 언약궤 앞에 쓰러져 있었고 사람들이 다시 세워놨지만 그 다음 날은 머리와 두 손목이 잘린 채로 무너져 있었던 거예요. 게다가 블레셋 사람들에게는 독한 종기가 생기면서 많은 사람이 죽어가기 시작했어요. 결국 블레셋 사람들은 자신들에게 재앙을 가져오는 이 여호와의 언약궤를 다시 이스라엘에 돌려보내기로 결정했지요. 언약궤는 정말로 하나님의 임재와 능력이 나타나는 신비한 성물이었고 여호와를 섬기지 않은 블레셋 사람들에게는 두려운 존재였던 거예요. 이 언약궤는 이스라엘로 무사히 돌아온 후에 20년 동안 아비나답의 집에 있었고 그때 이스라엘 온 백성들은 하나님을 간절히 찾았다고 해요. 사무엘은 온 백성들에게 이렇게 말해요. 만일 너희가 전심으로 여호와께 돌아오려거든 이방 신들과 우상을 너희 중에서 제거하고 너희 마음을 여호와께로 향하여 그만을 섬기라. 그리하면 너희를 블레셋 사람의 손에서 건져내시리라. 그리고 사람들을 미스바라고 하는 곳에 모두 모이라고 하고 그곳에서 함께 기도를 하기 시작해요. 이때 사무엘과 사람들이 한 기도는 바로 회개 기도였어요. 이스라엘 사람들은 미스바에 모여서 하루 종일 아무것도 먹지 않고 우리가 여호와께 범죄하였나이다 하며 그들의 잘못을 뉘우치고 하나님께 용서를 구하는 회개 기도를 간절하게 드린 거예요. 그런데 이렇게 많은 사람들이 미스바에 모여서 기도를 하고 있다는 소식을 들은 블레셋 군대가 또 쳐들어오는 거예요. 아, 정말 끈질기게 괴롭히네요. 하지만 이 전쟁의 결과는 어땠을까요? 사무엘과 이스라엘 사람들이 먼저 회개하고 여호와께 돌아와서 하나님만을 섬기기로 결정하며 기도했을 때 하나님은 이스라엘의 기도를 들어주셨고 이 전쟁에서 승리하게 했었어요. 이 전쟁에는 지난번처럼 언약궤를 가져오지 않았지만 사무엘과 백성들의 간절한 기도 가운데 하나님의 임재가 있었고 하나님의 도우심이 있었던 거예요. 전쟁에서 승리한 후에 사무엘은 돌을 하나 가져다가 미스바와 센 사이에 세워놓고 그 이름을 에벤에셀이라고 불렀어요. 그것은 바로 여호와께서 여기까지 우리를 도우셨다 라는 뜻이고 도움의 돌이라는 뜻도 돼요. 우리 친구들, 우리가 하나님을 믿고 섬기며 하나님의 도우심을 구할 때 가장 먼저 해야 할 일은 무엇일까요? 그것은 바로 회개예요. 그렇다면 회개가 뭘까요? 어떻게 하는 걸까요? 내가 잘못한 일이 있을 때 하나님 잘못했어요. 이번 한 번만 용서해 주세요. 하고 기도하면 끝일까요? 그 다음엔 또 내가 하고 싶은 대로 마음대로 하면서 살다가 또 이런 잘못을 반복하고 또 그럼 용서를 빌고 그게 진짜 회개일까요? 자, 우리 친구들 여기에 하나님의 구원의 은혜 그리고 축복이 들어있어요. 그리고 이것은 여러분 각자의 인생의 컵이에요. 자, 우리가 하나님의 은혜를 내 삶에 받고 싶은데 여러분의 컵이 이렇게 엎어져 있다면 어떨까요? 하나님이 우리에게 은혜를 주시려고 하시는데 단 하나도 담아지지가 않죠? 하나님이 우리에게 주시려는 은혜가 아무리 많아도 우리의 삶의 방향이 이렇게 잘못되어 있으면 그리고 하나님을 향해 있지 않으면 우리는 하나님께로부터 오는 그 무엇도 받을 수가 없어요. 회개라는 것은 바로 이런 거예요. 우리의 잘못된 생각, 태도, 삶의 방식들을 완전히 돌이키는 거예요. 어느 쪽으로요? 네. 하나님을 향한 쪽으로요. 자, 이렇게 방향을 완전히 바꿔서 바르게 놓으면 우리는 하나님께서 주시는 은혜와 축복을 이렇게 가득가득 받아 누릴 수가 있게 되는 거예요. 사도행전 3장 19절에는 그러므로 너희가 회개하고 돌이켜 너희 죄의 없이함을 받으라. 이같이 하면 새롭게 되는 날이 주 앞으로부터 이를 것이오 라고 말씀하고 있어요. 진정한 회개는 내가 지금까지 하나님보다 사랑했던 모든 것을 버리고 나의 우상이 되었던 것들을 다 내려놓고 하나님께로 돌이켜서 오직 하나님만을 섬기겠다는 결단이에요. 여러분들에게 그런 결단이 있을 때 도움의 돌이신 에벤에셀의 하나님이 여러분을 도와주실 거예요. 지금 우리에겐 이스라엘 사람들이 가지고 있던 언약궤가 없어요. 사실 그 언약궤는 2500년 전에 이 땅에서 사라져서 아직도 찾지 못하고 미스테리로 남아있다고 해요. 하지만 진짜 언약궤는 없어진 게 아니에요. 언약궤가 상징하고 있던 세 가지 모두가 지금 우리에게 있거든요. 하나님의 말씀이신 예수님이 이 땅에 오셨고 예수님의 피 흘리심으로 우리의 죄가 용서받았으며 하나님의 영이신 성령님을 통해서 우리는 하나님의 임재를 경험할 수가 있거든요. 우리를 향한 하나님의 도움은 이 약속의 말씀을 믿고 하나님께로 돌이켜 회개하는 것으로부터 시작된다는 사실을 꼭 기억하세요. 우리 친구들, 지난주 MVP 챌린지 성공하셨나요? 지난주 기도 주제는 감사였는데요. 이번 주 MVP 주제는 회개입니다. 친구들이 오늘 말씀을 통해 배운 것처럼 우리의 잘못을 하나님께 다 고백하고 용서를 구하는 것뿐만 아니라 이제는 정말 나의 삶의 방향을 하나님께로만 향하고 하나님만을 섬기며 살아가겠다는 결단도 함께 할 수 있기를 바라요. 일주일 동안 챌린지에 성공하고 인증샷 찍어서 전도사님한테 보내주는 것도 잊지 마시고요. 자, 그럼 이 시간 함께 기도하겠습니다. 하나님 아버지, 부끄러운 나의 죄를 고백합니다. 가족들과 친구들의 마음을 아프게 한 적도 있고 나 자신만을 위한 생각에 욕심을 부린 때도 많았어요. 또 내 마음속에 하나님보다 더 사랑한 것들이 있었음을 이 시간 고백합니다. 그런 일들로 하나님의 마음을 아프게 한 저의 모습을 용서해 주세요. 이제는 주님께로 돌아가겠습니다. 언제나 환영하며 받아주시는 하나님의 품으로 돌아가고 싶어요. 언제나 변함없이 나를 사랑하시는 하나님 한 분만을 섬기며 하나님의 뜻대로 살기를 원해요. 내 마음을 받아주세요. 예수님의 이름으로 기도드립니다. 아멘.
Thank you, God, for allowing me to worship today. Please join us so that all of our Chaser Church friends can be well throughout the week, throughout COVID-19. Please let the COVID-19 virus go away so we can pray together. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Let us do the offering prayer. Lord, thank you for this offering. We offer you little things we have. Please receive our offerings and our hearts and bless each one of us. We hope all of these offerings will be used for your glory and to extend the kingdom of God. In Jesus' name we pray, Amen.
못하니 내 모든 것 내어주고 나 그들을 얻으리라
Hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours now and forever. Amen.
First and foremost, happy birthday to Yujiwon and Han Shanon. Hope you guys have a lovely birthday. Secondly, please keep washing your hands and maintaining a safe social distance. Thirdly, please memorize 1 Samuel chapter 7 verse 12. It goes like this. Then Samuel took a stone and set it up between Mizpah and Shen. He named it Ebenezer, saying, Thus far has the Lord helped us. The fourth announcement. As you guys all know, we have started a new challenge for the whole Adongbu, including the teachers, called MVP. It stands for Morning Victory Prayer. This will be a prayer challenge for us all where on our way to school, in the car, or as you're walking, we're going to pray to God together. And it's very encouraging to know that at the same time, in the same morning, there are other brothers and sisters in Christ praying as well. And every week we have a theme that we pray together. This week's theme is going to be a prayer of confession, where you take 1 or 2 minutes of your morning confessing your sins to God, asking for forgiveness, and also asking for strength to not sin and to live a life that's pleasing in God's sight. And if you have prayed the MVP prayer from Monday all through to Friday, please write on a piece of paper MVP 성공 or MVP completed and send a photo of yourself holding that piece of paper to 전도사님 before 2 p.m. on Saturday. This is your fifth and last announcement. It will be about new friends wanting to join Sinichel Adongbu. During this COVID time, there are two different groups of friends that may be wanting to join our Sinichel Adongbu. The first group is called the membership group, where a friend may not be attending any church, not a member of any other church. And during this time, they are finding more interest in our videos, in our sermon videos, our Bible study videos, our praise and worship, or even our prayer challenge. These are the friends that we call the membership group. The second group will be called the fellowship group, where a friend may already be a member of another church. Before COVID, they were attending another church's Adongbu. But because of COVID and their Adongbu not going online, they have a desire to participate and be a member of our Adongbu online service and share in fellowship with our Adongbu 친구들 as well. So we just wanted to let you know that we are aware of two different types of groups of friends, and we welcome all of them. So if there are any friends who are wanting to become a member and join our Sinichel Adongbu, please ask them to send a video of themselves introducing who they are, what they like, their name, their age, their year, and send that video to 전도사님's Kakao ID right below. We look forward to meeting all your new friends. For now, stay safe and see you next week. Bye!
The three verse 10. Amen.
The Lord came and stood there.
The Lord came and stood there.
Samuel said, speak for your servant is listening. 1 Samuel chapter 3 verse 10.
Samuel 3:10.
The Lord came and stood there, calling at the time, Samuel. Samuel said,
Speak for your servant is listening. 1 Samuel chapter 3 verse 10. Amen.
Hey guys, it's us again. And guess what we're doing today?
Today? What are we doing, Shelly?
So we're at church right now to record a song to, I think it'll be on our sermon videos maybe next week or the week after. So we're just practicing and might record very soon.
Hope you guys like this song and please sing along with this song when it comes out. Thank you.
It was really hard to record, and I didn't really realize that it's that hard work.
Yeah, you know? It was a very hard process, but yeah, I think it turned out very well. So, hope you guys are excited for it.
Yeah.